bitter springs in Mataranka.
Yeah, and we're using noodles because you can't float.
And it's so nice, so peaceful. The water's clear.
And we need noodles.
It's very deep, and we need noodles. And I need noodles because I can't swim, unfortunately.
I need a noodle.
Thank you, Mauritius, for teaching me nothing.
Mataranka, we headed further north up to Katherine, and there are a couple of hot spots when we got to Katherine, the first of which was the Nipmuluk National Park. And as part of our trip to the Nipmuluk National Park, we took in a three-gorge tour, which was pretty much a full day's activity where we do a cruise across Katherine Gorge and get to check out all the sites and have a swim. As well as that, we also explored Edith Falls, which was probably one of the best waterfalls we visited of all of the Northern Territory. It was so much fun up there. We went to the top area, which was a little bit shorter to get to, if I recall. However, it was a bit steeper, but there wasn't many people and we had a great time jumping off the rocks and just enjoying time as a family. We continued our adventure further north and headed up to Kakadu National Park, which is only about 100 kilometres further north from Katherine, so it didn't take us very long. We set up camp alongside one of the billabongs just within inside the park, and it was only a stone's throw away to Jim Jim Falls from there. So once we'd set up the camper trailer, we headed onto Jim Jim Falls, and it was spectacular. Standing underneath that waterfall and looking up the 100 odd metres to the top of that waterfall, you feel so small, so tiny, and it just puts the whole world into perspective.
Finally at Jim Jim Falls, right here in the middle of, where are we, Tim?
We are in Kakadu National Park.
Kakadu National Park, which is a crocodile infested area. There's crocodiles everywhere, so no matter how great the water looks, you can't swim in any of these water.
Well, they've got croc traps around here, but they say it's not safe to swim, but we'll have a swim up in the plunge pool up a little bit further. How gorgeous is this? Some of the more spiritual elements of Kakadu, rather than simply swimming in the waterfall plunge pools all day, even though it was a perfectly sound approach to beating the heat. So we came up with the idea of visiting Nalangi Rock, and we happened to also pick Nalangi Rock on a 40 plus degree weather day, which made it incredibly hot for all of us. Nalangi Rock was once the home of the local indigenous that date back over 20,000 years ago, and there is evidence of them living under the rock or around the Nalangi Rock, and shows where they would have been able to gather as a tribe, prepare their meals, and of course there is some absolutely spectacular rock art dotted all around there.
I walk through fire to save my life, and the one that I want.
we're in Litchfield National Park, in the Lost City. That is about 20 kilometres from
Florence Falls. And this is the rock formations in Lost City.
That they call it, Lost City because the rocks look like buildings.
Yeah, and we had to take a four-wheel drive track to get there. Only four-wheel drive can access this place.
Yep.
Gorgeous. Isn't it, Kat?
Yeah.
We are at the rock formation that I called the Titanic, because it looks like the Titanic.
Do you think it's going to sink, Zoe?
It already has.
It already has.
Part of it has sunk.
Are you going to sail that all the way back to Melbourne?
No. That's probably going to be really hard.
I don't know whether it would float very well being a rock.
Litchfield National Park was incredible. It's a smaller, unknown sibling to Kakadu, but as a result it has less crowds and it's much easier to get around. But that doesn't mean it's not as good as Kakadu. Litchfield, in my opinion, is also home to some of the best waterfalls in Australia, and not just one or two, there are plenty, some even requiring a four-wheel drive to access them. Now, having access to an endless array of swimming spots is a very important feature when trying to survive the constant furnace of the Northern Territory dry season. Temperatures were constantly in the high 30s, and finding a spot to cool off was essential for the entire family. We checked out Wangy Falls, Florence Falls, the Bewley Rockholes, Tejanera Falls, and our favourite was Surprise Falls. Each was different, but because Surprise Falls was so remote and difficult to get to, needing a four-wheel drive with a snorkel, it made the stunning scenery so much better when we got there. Plus, there were plenty of spots where we could jump in from the surrounding rocks, or just laze about and soak up some sun.
Hey guys, we are currently at Jawara Falls. And it is about 11 o'clock in the morning. We've driven through four-wheel drive track. We finally got to go through a river with our car. We used the snorkel to go through it. And as you can see, it's amazing. There's great spots to jump there. There's a bit of sun at the moment, but around 2:30 the sun comes right down where the fall is. Makes it feel better soon. The water temperature is great. It's quite warm here. Pretty good. Love it. And I've got a coffee, and this is the best spot in town right now. Look at that. I didn't even lean.
Well, that's it, folks. That's the end of this video series on our trip to the Northern Territory. I hope you enjoyed all the scenery. It was a blast visiting these spots, and even though they might not have been the steadiest of shots, I'm sure you'll all agree it's still a beautiful part of the world. If you ever get the chance to do a trip like this with your family, you gotta do it. You'll love it, they'll love it. Yeah, it's hard work and it's lots of effort, but when you think about the sights that we all saw and the experiences we shared, you know the effort was well worth it. I know I'll definitely come back and visit the Northern Territory again. This place, it really leaves its stamp on you.